Now, onto my duck breasts. I'm going to locate this breastplate. This is the breastplate, as I mentioned before. It sticks up from the rest of the cavity, which is quite cylindrical. So this breastplate sticks up about half an inch. I'm going to take my knife and run right along the top of that breastplate. And what that's going to do is it's just going to cut open the skin, so this way I can fully expose my breastplate. And then I'm going to take, pressing down through the flesh, but keeping the face of my knife right up against that breastplate, I'm going to make a cut down to where the cavity begins to take shape. It's extremely red. This is why, you know, it's redder than my cutting board. And this is why, like, if you were to take this and put it up against, let's say, a piece of venison, they're about the same color, that really dark purple color. And so this is why I do not treat this meat as I would a chicken breast. A classical way of cooking duck breast would be to score the breast just like so. I would season it with salt, pepper, maybe just a dash of sugar. And then I would sear the fat cap down. Once I get, you know, just the juices in the fat cap ignited, I would then turn it around on that same pan and then just allow the breast to cook for another few minutes on the other side and then pull it off and have a nice, rare duck breast. So I'm going to do the same thing with my other duck breast. And there you go. Now, the rest of this cavity, this is what I would use to make a duck sauce, a duck jus. Duck sauce and duck jus is one of those items that it's just, you know, it's just so nice. There's nothing, there's not much better than a nice reduction of a duck sauce. Duck soup is absolutely stunning. Sweet and sour duck soup, spicy duck soup. It's, you know, it's such a delicacy to have duck stock. And so these duck bones definitely do not go to waste. All the meat that you can get out of here afterwards from braising it off is just going to be, you know, an added bonus. But otherwise, there is no quick and easy method to be able to do the rest of this work because of how fit this bird is, muscle-wise. For me to start deboning wings of that nature for muscle, it's not going to be worth very many people's time. Whereas if you were to braise it off and then just pull it off the bone, you'll be able to get that meat a lot better. It'll be tender, it'll be ready for you to eat.